Hello friends, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we are going to learn how to count set bits in an integer. The problem says that given an integer, say n, and we are required to devise an efficient way for computing the number of set bits in its binary representation. Let's understand a given problem with the help of an example. For example, if n is equals to 6, then by looking at its binary representation, we can see that the number of set bits is 2. And if n is equals to 13, we see 3 set bits in its binary representation. Now, how do we solve the given problem efficiently? Let's start with a naive approach to this problem, and afterwards we will discuss two other approaches that are more efficient. A simple approach which comes to mind first is to check every single bit in the given integer and count the number of set bits among them. The implementation is quite obvious. Here we have a function named countSetBits which takes the unsigned integer n as the argument. Now we first initialize the count variable with 0 and then we run a while loop that iterates over all the bits of n. At every iteration of the while loop, we check whether the binary bit is set or not, that is, whether the binary bit is 1 or 0. We check this by performing the bitwise AND operation on the binary bit with 1. Note that the bitwise AND operation returns 1 only if both the supplied operands are 1. So if the bit is set, we increment the count variable by 1. After this, we write shift n by 1 to drop the checked bit. The loop ends when n becomes 0. At last, we return the count variable. The complexity analysis of this approach is as follows. Since the loop iterates over all the bits in the given integer and n has log of n number of bits in its binary representation, the algorithm takes theta of log n in time. And since our space requirements remain constant throughout, the space complexity remains big O of 1. A trickier observation one can make is that whenever we subtract any number by 1, then initially the rightmost set bit becomes 0, and then all the bits to the right of the rightmost set bit are flipped. For example, if n is equals to 9, having the binary representation of 1001, on subtracting 1 from 9, we get 8. And we see that the rightmost set bit becomes 0. Again, subtracting 1 from 8, we get 7. And we see that the rightmost set bit in 8 is now unset. And all the bits to its right are flipped. This unsetting of the rightmost set bit is useful for us, but at the same time, we need to suppress the toggling effect, which is unwanted. One such algorithm to achieve this is the Kernighan's algorithm. In the Kernighan's algorithm, we first initialize the count variable with 0. Now, until n becomes 0, we perform the bitwise AND operation over n and n-1. This suppresses the toggling effect, and since in every iteration we unset the rightmost set bit, we increment the counter in each iteration. Take the same example again. First perform the bitwise AND operation between 9 and 8 and we get 8 itself. Then we increment the counter, and since 8 is not equal to 0, we again perform the bitwise AND operation between 8 and 7, which gives us 0. We increment the counter again and it becomes 2. Now n is equal to 0 and we can't proceed any further. Let's have a look at the implementation of this algorithm. Here in the countSetBits function, we first initialize the count variable with 0. Then inside while loop, we update n with the bitwise AND operation between n and n-1 and increment the counter count. After the loop terminates, we return the value stored in the count variable. Let's now figure out the complexity of this algorithm. Since here, we efficiently iterate for each set bit in the given integer n, we have the time complexity of the order of set bits in n. In the worst case, it gives us big O of log n in time. And similar to the simple solution, our space requirements remain constant throughout here as well. So the space complexity remains order of 1. Now, in addition to the two algorithms that we covered, there's another efficient approach which utilizes some pre-processing to further reduce the time complexity. Here, we group some bits together, say 4, and store the corresponding number of set bits in a lookup table. For example, we have all the 4 bits integer and the corresponding count stored in the lookup table. Now, whenever we are given an integer, we can perform constant time lookups. Here, the number of lookups for a given integer is equal to log of n, that is the number of binary bits in the given integer, divided by k, where k is the number of bits grouped together. In this case, 4. To calculate the count of set bits, we can simply add the counts returned by the lookups. For example, if n is equals to 254, which has the given binary representation with 7 set bits, now the count of set bits in the lower nibble is 3, while we have all 4 bits set in the upper nibble. Hence, we get a total of 7 as the output. Let's run the code for the above approach at the GeeksforGeeks IDE. So here we have the GeeksforGeeks ID. Now we first set all the values in the table and look for the number of set bits in each set of 4 bits by performing the bitwise AND operation with 0xf. We repeat this step until n becomes 0. Let's see the output with n is equals to 254. And we get the output as 7, which is the correct answer. The lookup approach requires one iteration per 4 bits in this case, but we can pre-process the table for any number of bits. Hence, the number of iterations would depend upon the system. In general, for the k-bit system, our time complexity will grow at the rate of log of n divided by k. And this would become the best case when k becomes equal to log n, as the complexity becomes big O of 1. Since we maintain a lookup table here, we are using extra space that grows at the rate of 2 raised to the power k. So for a k-bit system, the space complexity becomes order of 2 raised to the power k. Let's now have a quick recap at all the ways in which we can count the number of set bits in an integer. Initially, we looked at the naive solution to the problem, which gave us the theta of log n as the time complexity. Then later on, we saw Brian Kernighan's algorithm, which solved the problem in order of log of n. At last, we learned the lookup approach, which utilized some pre-processing to solve the problem. Now, apart from the 3 algorithms we discussed, if you are required to count the number of set bits frequently, say in programming competitions or anywhere else, then you can use a direct built-in function in GCC called __built_in_popcount. This function takes an integer argument and returns the number of set bits in the given integer. So that's all for now. I hope you have understood all the ways in which we can count the number of set bits in an integer. Thanks for watching. Please leave us your comments.